So good evening. At the outset, I would like to thank the Director of Medical Sciences, Dr. Vijay Chakkan, Dr. Sangeeta, Medical Superintendent, and the hospital management for giving me an opportunity to talk on this Facebook platform. So to introduce myself, I'm Dr. Sunil. I'm a senior consultant neurosurgeon at SIMS Hospital, Vadapalani. I have 6 years experience in the field of neurosurgery, and I have exposure to all major neurosurgical procedures. I work in the department of neurosurgery at SIMS Hospital, headed by Dr. Suresh Babu, and then we have Dr. Vijay Shankaran and Dr. Vishwaraj as senior consultants. We have three more supporting qualified neurosurgeons and two DNB neurosurgery PGs. So we are a big department and do all major neurosurgical procedures every day. To going into the topic of the day, I'm going to talk about the surgical aspects of epilepsy. So it's like surgery for disease called epilepsy. So epilepsy is commonly, we know in common terms as fits, or in Tamil they say kaka valipu, and in Telugu they call it as morcha vyadi and dore panna in Hindi. So they are known in different languages, they are known by different names. In medical terms, in common medical language, it is called a seizure. So a seizure, if it happens again and again, like a fits happening again and again, the disease is called epilepsy. So this epilepsy can be disastrous to the patient, because he can have he will become unconscious, fall, and have a injury. He'll bite the tongue. But as such, the episodes will be self-contained. They stop after a few minutes, and the patient will go into a state of unconsciousness. To understand this, I'll just compare it with a terrorist attack. A terrorist attack a place, and like it happens suddenly. They damage the properties. They cause danger to the lives. So it is like that. Something happening in one part of the brain, it starts some abnormal part of the brain, one normal brain which has turned abnormal, and it discharges a lot of electrical disturbances all over the brain. So suddenly patient becomes unconscious and falls down, have the convulsions, and he'll go into a sleep-like state for a few hours, then he wakes up after everything subsides in the brain. So this is the overall picture of an epilepsy, how it happens. So the basic problem is one part of the brain that has become aberrant, and it is functioning in an abnormal way. Okay, it is sending abnormal signals all over the brain, and it is causing damage. So as a surgeon, as a neurosurgeon, we investigate and try to localize, find out which part of the brain is the cause. Once we are able to find out the cause, like after doing various tests, we go and operate and remove that aberrant part of the brain, that abnormal part of the brain. Once we remove that, it is almost like cure for the patient. The seizures, episodes can stop. So this is one of the major advantages of a surgery for an epilepsy patient. So it can become curative, like he may not need further long-standing treatments like that. The otherwise, what happens is patients will be started on medicines. They will be continued for years together. It is estimated that average period of referral to a non-medical management, like for surgery or something, is about 18 years. So patients will be subjected to medications for almost for several years before they are even referred to a surgeon for a case. This is one disadvantage with medicines. And at the same time, the medicines can cause a lot of side effects in the due course of the treatment. So to avoid all this, a surgery can become a very good tool for giving cure and also avoiding the medical related side effects. Another major advantage is the cost effectiveness. The cost of drug treatment extending for some years is much higher than what a surgical procedure or anything can give. So how do we find that abnormal part of the brain which is causing this damage? So we have to select a patient properly. It is estimated like about 1,000 eligible patients, only 2 people are getting operated in India at present. The whole burden, if you look, the whole disease burden, if you look, it is about 12 million people having epilepsy, of which most of the people are may benefit from surgical procedures. But only very few centers, as of now we can say about 30 centers in India are working for epilepsy surgery. There is a large treatment gap. This treatment gap is because of lack of awareness among the people and even some of the medical fraternity. Then and mostly they continue on medical treatment. When we say surgery, okay, the patients get scared and they say, okay, let us continue on medicines and avoid surgery. We don't want someone to put hands on my brain like that. So actually surgery can be very safe. Recent advances have improved our OT techniques and a lot of adjuncts have helped us to improve the safety and outcomes also. So in our hospital we have a very good OT setup. We have a large microscope. Then our team of anesthetists and staff are well trained and equipped. And most importantly, we have neuro monitoring. This neuro monitoring done by Dr. Nishant in our hospital, he will help us once we do operation. We try to get signals where the seizures, like particularly starting, we can get the signals directly from the brain. This recording was done by Dr. Nishant. So once we are able to remove the tumor, we'll again check whether any part is still giving seizures, giving abnormal signals or not. So in that way, we improve the efficacy of surgery and safety of surgery. Tumors can be the lesions, whatever the causing epilepsy, they can sometimes involve main motor functional areas, like some speech area on the left side, or the nerves that come to the hands and legs on one side. If it is involved like that, then mostly surgically it may not be cured. Okay, so those people we have to continue on medicines. This is one of the contraindications for surgery. How do we select patients? So, to know whether a patient is eligible or not, we have to do certain tests. The main tests, like we divide into invasive and non-invasive. Non-invasive is like which is done first. A non-invasive test group of it includes like MRI scan. MRI should be a 3 Tesla MRI ideally, or a good scanning machine with 1.5 also can give good details. Then we have to do a video EEG recording. EEG is like what we do routinely for a heart ECG. So for the brain, it is called EEG. This EEG will be done in a video setup, and it will be continuously monitored for a long duration, about 8 hours to 12 hours, or even sometimes for days, 1 or 2 days. The whole idea of video EEG and recording is like whenever the seizure happens. So it gives the recordings from which side of the brain is coming or which part of the brain is more involved in this seizure. So MRI and video EEG are main tools. Then we have to do PET CT. PET CT is something, a dye is injected and see which part of the brain is more active, which part of the brain is less active. So a less active brain is more can be a cause for seizures. So these tests we do, and then we assess the patient psychologically, like he should not have any depression or severe psychiatric diseases. These patients, after doing all these tests, we select them, and what we need is the concordance in clinical seizure. So while seeing the video EEG and the recordings, we'll get a idea. And then the same, for example, if a particular patient having a seizure, we record it and identify it like it is coming from right side. Then we have to do MRI and see on the right side of the brain any particular area is involved like that. Then PET-CT also should be correlating that on the right side there is less active area. So if that concordance is achieved, okay, so we can, these patients are suitable for surgery. Particular reason for surgery is those who are medically, like for example, if a patient is having seizures, once you start one drug and if it is getting well controlled, usually they control it, they continue the medications for some time. But as the disease progresses, they keep adding more drugs because the fits seizures go out of control. Then we increase the dosages, like if two or three drugs and increase high dosages, they can cause a lot of damage to the brain as such with a lot of side effects. So in those patients, we do all these tests and we decide on surgery. So, one second, what are the questions? So this is a basic, I just want to give idea for any other questions, that's all. Can you break? Okay, so I thank everyone for paying attention to my talk, and hope my talk can inspire or be benefited to at least one patient who have epilepsy. Thank you.